finally, we have one tool that includes prompt generation, image generation, image restyling, background removal, 3D generation, and we can even edit AI texture. Hey guys, this is Stefan, and I found something interesting for you. So I was looking for these guys for some time, but now I see they improved a lot, and this tool actually have everything you need if you're creating 3D models and basically working with AI. We're talking about 3D AI Studio, so you can take a look on their website. I already got my account set up, and first cool feature is that you can organize everything inside with very easy access. So my task for today will be the following. I want to come up with the cat in a steampunk style. I also want it to have some arcane and frogpunk vibes in terms of styles. Well, little bit specific task, but let's try. So first of all, let's create a project. Well, let's give it a straightforward name. Let's open the project. So the first thing is actually prompting, right? And sometimes it might take a while, right? And what I appreciate in 3D AI Studio that if we go to Image Studio, first of all, we can see rich selection of AI models and tools. But that's not how we start. We start from creating a prompt. And they have really amazing tool called Craft a Prompt. Let's say I already have my basic prompt, which is very short, but you know, that might be not enough. And what's good here is that I have few reference images that I want to use for a style. But how I can approach it, I can go to ChatGPT or Claude or any other AI and ask to describe this, extract the style, etc. And it might take a while. What I will do instead is I will select an image, let's say the arcane one. Then I will select the reference focus character style, and I also will choose 3D stylized as I want a 3D character, right? And I will press enhance prompt. Just in seconds, we have everything done. And guys, trust me, this really saves time. So what I can do is that I can copy it, replace it here, and let's add my another image, a frogpunk reference. So here it is, and let's press enhance prompt. Okay, so in just seconds, we got it. So now with this prompt, we can go further. You can also notice that you can actually extract from image. So you can put an image and extract the text, which might be easier than going to ChatGPT and asking like, here, this is the image, please extract me the prompt, blah, blah, blah. Well, small feature, but extremely useful. The next thing, whenever we happy with our prompt, we need to create image. So here we go to generate, and there's plenty of models, and there are some specialized model that you can choose from, but I really appreciate GPT image one. I think this one follows my prompts exactly, especially if they are a little bit tricky. For more realistic character or objects or whatever, you might like to use Flex or another, but let's do ChatGPT image. So there are basic settings. I will do high, I will do auto, and let's create four images. All right, so after a while, we have our results. And well, this is actually really nice. And I have two candidates I want to proceed with. Well, as you can see, it do have this vibrant color from Frogpunk. And the style is really look like arcane, like this hand-drawn. Well, this is really great job. Okay, let's choose this one. So before we move to 3D model creation, we might need some adjustment to the image. So first of all, this look a little bit too much like a painting, and I want to make it more 3D-ish. And first, we also need to remove background. This is important to remove backgrounds because many 3D generation model do might cause some artifacts from shadows, etc. So even if your image is created on a transparent background, trust me, you need to remove background even though there is nothing to remove because there are invisible artifacts from AI generation on the image. So you always can go to dashboard and to your project, and here you can see find our generation. So this one that I like is right here. So what we're gonna do, we can press remove background and wait a little bit. Alternatively, you can go to Image Studio and there are tilts, and there are remove background, there are upscale, upscale clarity, definitely thing that we can try. Okay, let's go back. So the next step is we can actually use it for 3D generation and we can actually use it from here. But for me, I really want it look more like 3D. So what we're gonna do is go to Image Studio. There is an amazing category called Convert, where we can actually convert it. So there are many tools. I really like the convert anything, but for this purpose, I will use stylize it with render because this is exactly what I need. Okay, so let's go here. Let's select our image. So the only thing I will add here is a pose, and let's do it.
A few moments later.
All right, so here is the result. I mean, I really like this because again, it really keeps all the features, but now it looks like a 3D model. Perhaps it loses some style details, but that's what I call 3D render style. So let's go to back to dashboard and let's also remove the background. So we will try to create 3D models from both of the image and see how it looks. I want to show you one another cool tool called image reference, where instead of creating a prompt the way I showed you, you can basically go here and put your prompt here, and here you can select up to 5 images that will be used as a style reference. Insert your prompts and actually create images, and the result here might be even better. So here is some results that I managed to achieve here. I mean, this one looked not exactly what I wanted, but this guy really looked cool. Guys, before we proceed, if you like this video, please consider subscribe and press like on this video. It really motivates me to make better content for you guys. Alright, so now let's go back to dashboard and let's create 3D models. So you can go to image 3D and select the image, or you can just press an image that you want to convert to 3D and press this, load an image to 3D. As easy as it can be. So here we have few models and we can learn about them by pressing here. So Swift is the quick, Forge is good for nice geometry, and Prism is the best one that they have right now. So I tested all of them and I would say I really like the Prism a lot, and Forge might be useful sometime, but it's not even close to Prism. So by default it's selected. Let's see what advanced options we have. There are a few that we might take a look. The PBR, I really don't like PBR all the time, so we can test with PBR, but normally it just adds like glossy feeling, etc. I really like it without it, so I will uncheck it. And for texture quality, I usually go for detailed, so my texture look better, but it will take a little bit more time. Okay, while I press generate, I can go back to my dashboard as I created a task, and you can see it's already here, and go to another cat. And let's do the same. Let's go advanced option. I will also enable PBR, especially with style like this. PBR is definitely something we don't need, and texture quality detailed. And as a bonus, let's also create this guy. Okay, so the first model is already completed, so let's review. And guys, one thing I really like about Prism is that it takes way less time than another model I use. So there is Rodin, there are Hunion 2.5, and I would say like at least twice it is faster. But the quality is still on a decent level. So guys, you can judge. I really like the output. It's really clean. It's exactly my prompt, not much of the artifacts. Even though I would say texture is not 100% perfect, but that's the problem of all models right now. But here we can actually adjust the texture, and I will show you how just in a second. So here we can download it as a GLB, but optionally we can also download it as STL, which might be good for 3D printing, etc. We can also remesh it. So if we are not happy with the polygons, etc., we can remesh it for our further use. We can retexture it. We'll see it later. We can put it into a 3D library, and we can create LODs for in-game use. So we don't need that right now. Let's review another models. Okay, so our another model is done as well. And guys, even though it's a little bit dark, I really like how good it is styled. It does follow the prompt, I mean, these shades, all the things. Guys, this is really good. I would love to see if it's a little bit less dull, but even though it's fine. And our last one also look really good, But here I can see a little bit artifacts from sides. Not critical, but the face is amazing. Wow. I mean, I'm really impressed by the quality for such complex character, the texture, the mesh, etc. Now guys, I want to show you what can happen if you did not remove the background even though you use transparent background. So here is an image I created with ChatGPT 4.0, and you can see it's a transparent background. But the problem is, again, because of the alpha layer, we don't see invisible artifacts there. And because of the alpha layer, we cannot see it. Now, look, if I use this to create 3D model, and guys, if you think this might be only problem of this model, no. I tested Tripo, I tested Hunyuan 2.5, and same problem happens there because of the alpha layer cover some artifacts. So again, the fix is very easy. You just take the image that doesn't have background, you still remove the background with the tool here or any other tool, and then it results a perfect model, no artifacts from the back. Amazing. Now guys, as promised, let's explore how we can improve textures and repaint texture right here. So we can go to texture AI and it will open something like this. So what's happening here? So we have a model and we have a screen where we can create a texture on top of that, and we can paint on top newly generated texture, we can paint on top of our model and save the result. So first we go here and we select a model. I really like Flux Texture AI Experimental, but you can try another. So we have default prompt here and we can play with the creativity. So let's give it a try. So when we press generate texture, you can see it's a nice animation, and you can see it actually take the screenshot as reference and improve it. So what I can see here is that the mouth here is much more interesting than my model have. So how I transfer this to here? Basically, I go to brush and you can see white circle on top of the model. I will adjust brush strength a little bit more, and brush hardness I will go a little bit more to 65. Now I will paint on top of here like that, and as you can see my texture is now updated. The nose is more accurate, it's now like here. So the more brush strength we add, the more direct effect it takes, right? So if I add more and go paint these goggles, you can see there is no scar here. And this is amazing because if you have almost perfect model and you just need few tweaks and you are not Blender expert or texture artist, look, there are few artifacts here and here. Let's press create texture, generate texture, and try to fix it. Okay, so texture updated, you can see now there is no artifacts. Let's just paint on top and boom, now I just fixed the artifact. So sometimes the generated image doesn't cover the artifacts. In that case, you can add to creativity a little bit more and it will make a better prompt ignoring the original images, and you can paint on top. Adding too much, my results not good. So in my opinion, what you can do is just try to generate a few times until you have the nice result. And now, for example, yeah, this is what I want. Boom, fix it. And the coolest thing here is that you don't need to go anywhere else. So we can export it by pressing here, or we also can save the results to our dashboard. All right, and now everything is organized in here. You can see everything you did, right? Step by step, I really like it. It's very easy to navigate. You can filter, you can search, you can always go back and continue. So here is our edited model, right? We can go back, we can download it, we can adjust texture more, we can create LODs and so on. But even though this is already a lot of tools, you can also find out that they have more tools that you can reach out. Like if you go to Quick Utilities, you have like SVG, 3D Text, Image to Video, Image to Prompt, which is similar to what I show you. And Prompt Creation, there are Text to Audio, LoRa Studio, Remesh Tool, 3D Bureau. So very useful can be a Remesh Tool. If you create a character and then you need to fit some specific polygon requirements, you're creating some mobile games, etc. Might be very useful. But there's also a cool thing called Lora, where you can actually train your Loras, use some Loras. So a quick example might be that, for example, this is a really cool claymation Lora. And here's how it works. You basically go here, you enter a prompt, you add a trigger word from the Lora. This is important. And let's actually create our character in claymation. So I'll add a prompt here. And I will press add, so it adds the trigger word. All right, so I will keep it as default, and let's press generate image. So here we go, like, it's quite funny character. So last but not least, there is Learning Studio, where they actually create quite cool tutorials. It's very easy to follow, and I actually watch a few of them myself and learn something new. So guys, if you are serious about improving your skills, how to use this tool, and on a professional level, take a look on this area. For 3D artists, there is texture generator, where can you put your 3D object, which is not textured, upload the reference image, and it will actually texture it on a very good quality. And there is a seamless texture generator, which is very, very useful if you are a 3D artist developing interiors, exteriors. Seamless texture always are in need. That's it, guys. If you like this video, please consider subscribe, and I see you in the next video very soon.